Okay, let's start working with your contact list now. The first thing you're going to want to learn is how to filter and search your contact list. To get started, all you have to do is click on this blue bar where it will bring up two tabs, one for filtering and one for searching. When you're filtering, you have the ability to select a whole bunch of different criteria to determine which contacts show up in the list below. You can select the primary agent that you want to view if it is a brokerage or a brokerage plus site. You could select the different lead types. You could sort by a whole bunch of different criteria. You can select the source of the lead, whether it be AdWords, Bing, Google, Facebook. You can select different filter by options like have they visited recently? Have they looked at more than 10 properties? Have they saved homes? You could specify the transaction type, whether they're buyers, sellers, or CMA requesters. You can also look at price ranges of homes they're clicking on. So you could set the price range from, the price range to, and you can also additionally select a city to be the target of those homes that they're clicking on as well. So in this example, if I wanted to see all leads who have clicked on homes in Draper, I could set that, hit the refresh button, and now it's going to show me all leads who have looked at homes in that area. Again, you just click on the filter bar, make selections for those things that you want to see, and then hit the refresh button. Okay? Now, let's say that you've done a filter and you had a whole bunch of different options selected and you just wanted to start over. You could do that by clicking the reset button. When you click the reset button, the filter will be reset to the initial values and it will show all the lists that are available within your contact list. So again, to filter, click on the blue bar at the top, set the different settings that are required for your contact list display, and then click the refresh button. If you want to reset the list, click the reset button. Now you can also search for contacts. When you click on the search tab, you have the ability to put in a last name or a partial last name, the email address, an MLS number if you want to see all the contacts who have looked at a specific listing, or you could put in the last four digits of their phone number. So in this example, I'm going to type GRE so that I can see all leads whose last name begins with GRE. When I click search, it'll bring up that list. Okay, now let me go back to the filter, and I'm going to reset the filter here. And notice down at the bottom, it shows you how many pages there are. A page has 100 contacts on it. So in this example, we're displaying 1,097 contacts. To go through it one page at a time, I can utilize the page forward, the page back, go to the end of the file, go to the beginning of the file, and I can also refresh the entire list by clicking the refresh button. Okay, so I hope that helps you understand how you see your contacts. You have to get used to using this filter option to get the specific list that you're looking for. For example, if I only wanted to see new contacts, I can click on the lead type new and then hit the refresh button. If I wanted to see them sorted by most recent visit, I could do that as well. I have new leads. I'm going to go to the sort by and put in most recent and then hit refresh. That's how simple it is to organize your contact list. Another nice feature of the contact list is the ability to control which columns are shown. Over here on the right, you'll see a button that is labeled columns. When I click on that button, I have the ability to move columns in or out of the display. So if I wanted to add the home phone, all I'd have to do is drag it from the right column into the left column and then drop it in the order that I want it to display. So in this example, I'm going to drop it under the cell phone so it shows up right next to the cell phone. When I click the button that says click here to save all changes, you'll notice that the home phone is now being displayed. Again, you have the ability to change which columns are shown, and you can also change the order that they're shown. So if I wanted to show the home phone first, I could grab it, drag it up, and drop it above the cell phone. When I hit the button to save, you'll see that it switched positions. Another thing you need to be aware of when using the contact list are these checkboxes to the left. The CRM gives you the ability to do mass changes or send mass email based upon the selection that you make here. Let's say, for example, that I wanted to send an email to Douglas Green and to Jordan Rupp at the same time. I can click those two checkboxes and then hit the email button. Now I have the ability to send an email to those two contacts at the same time. Notice when nothing is selected, these buttons gray out. That means they're not available unless you've selected at least one lead over here by clicking on the checkbox. If I wanted to select all the leads that are currently shown within the contact list, I can click the button at the top, the checkbox at the top, and they'll all be selected. And then at that point, I have access to be able to reassign those leads to a different agent, email them a mass email, change their lead types, or delete them. One note about deleting, if you delete your contacts, they are not recoverable. That's why we give you this warning, so be careful there. The next item we're going to talk about is the calendar. If you go ahead and click on the button on the left labeled calendar, it'll bring up a calendar showing you all the appointments, reminders, and deadlines that you have set within the CRM. You can click on an appointment, reminder, or deadline, double-click on it, and it will show you the detail. You can modify this detail if you want. You can delete it, or you could save it. Now, if I wanted to add a specific appointment, reminder, or deadline for someone, I could do that by double-clicking on the day, selecting whether it's an appointment, reminder, or deadline. Then I can click on the contact and select the contact that it's for. Now, you notice in this example, it only brings up two contacts to select from. That is because if you go back to the contact list, you can see I've done a filter or a search, and I've brought up these two contacts. If I go back to the filter and do a reset, in which case I have all the contacts displayed, I can then go to my calendar, double-click on the day again, and you'll see I have access to all the contacts. Okay? So let me go back and do my search again, bring up those two contacts, and now I'll click the calendar one more time. And to add, like I was saying, you can add an appointment, reminder, or deadline by just double-clicking on the day, selecting the type of event that it is. In this case, we'll make it an appointment. Select the contact that you want to assign it to, and then put in the start date and time. And a description. Once that's complete, click the Save button, and you'll see that the appointment has been added to the calendar. Now let's say that she changes the day that she wants to go out and do showings. So to do that change, the easiest way to make a change to the day, as long as the time hasn't changed, is to just drag the appointment over and drop it on the new day. And now you can see by double-clicking on it that the day has been changed to the 9th in this example. Okay, again, you have the ability to view your appointments, reminders, and deadlines by month format, week format, day format, the agenda format. You can switch the months in this example by clicking on these buttons. And if this is a brokerage or a brokerage plus site, you have the ability to select the agent that you want to see the appointments, reminders, and deadlines for. So the calendar is a quick way to get a look at what's going on right now in terms of your appointments, reminders, and deadlines. Another way to view your open appointments, reminders, and deadlines is to utilize the task list, which again is a button over here on the left. When I click on the task list, it's going to show me all the appointments, reminders, and deadlines that are due on or before the specified date. It'll always start out with today's date, but you have the ability to change that by clicking on the date icon and then selecting a new date. After doing that, click the reload button and it will bring up all the appointments, reminders, and deadlines based upon that date. Within this view, you have the ability to click on the lead if you want to go to their detail information. You can click on their phone number if you want to make a phone call to them. You can click view again to go to the lead's detail information. You can click notes to see any notes that have been added for that lead. You can click mark complete if you want to complete this appointment reminder or deadline, and you can delete it from here as well. So this is a handy way for you to get in and work any appointments, reminders, or deadlines on a daily basis. As I mentioned before, when you select one or more leads by clicking on the checkbox to the left of their name, these four buttons will light up. The first of those buttons, Assign, gives you the ability to assign these leads to a different agent. So if I wanted to assign these two leads to the agent Douglas Green, I can select Douglas Green as the agent and then click on the Change Assigned Agent button. When it does that, it changes the agent that the leads are assigned to, and it also sends that agent an email and a text message notifying them that the leads have been assigned to them. Now, in addition to assigning the leads to another agent, you can also send an email to those selected leads. Just click on the email button and it'll bring up the email editor where you have the ability to put in a subject, one or more MLS numbers separated by commas, and a body of the email. Once you've done that, you can preview the email by clicking the Preview Email button, which I highly recommend, and it will send you a copy of the email so you can verify that it's set up the way you want it. Once you like the way it looks, click the Queue button, and it will queue the email to send. Mass email are all sent at the top of every hour, and they're sent individually. It's not a BCC, it's an individual email sent to each lead. Now, we also give you access to something that we call the Content Catalog. This is a catalog of pre-written email that we provide you and any email that you've created as templates. When you click on the Content Catalog, it brings up this dialog where you can select your templates, or if you click on this dropdown, any of these sections that begins with the word live are pre-written email that we've created for you. So if I want to go to the buyer section, I can click on that. And then here are the pre-written email that are available. Let's say I want to send the luxury home buyer email. I'll just click on that. You can preview it here on the right. And then if that's the one you want to use, click insert. And now that email will be inserted into the body of the email and into the subject. Now notice down here that we've put bracket FNAME end bracket instead of the lead's actual name. Well, that's because we're sending it to multiple leads. So we can't type in the lead's name here or it will be incorrect for all the other leads that it goes to. So in this example, if you use what's called a mail merge field, which will be bracket FNAME end bracket, then when the email is sent, this will be replaced with the actual lead's first name. And if you scroll down on this page, you can see that there's an example down below of the different mail merge fields that you can utilize. Okay, so at this point I can preview it, and if I like the way it looks in my email, then I can go ahead and queue it to send. Now, there's a limit that we impose, which is that you can only send a mass email to a person once a day. So if I was sent that mass email and then you queued up another one, you would see that I'm not available to send to that day. That's because I've already received one. Now, another thing you can do in mass is to change the lead type. When I click on this button, I have the ability to go ahead and change the lead type from the current lead type to another one. So if I wanted to change both of these leads over to the client lead type, I could do that by clicking client and then change lead type here, in which case I'm going to get a warning. And if I approve that warning, it will go ahead and make that change. So if you wanted to change the lead type in mass, you would select those leads that you want to change the lead type for, and then you would click the lead type button. Of course, you can go to the agents or the leads individual record and change the lead type there as well. We'll show you that in a few minutes here. Now, the fourth option that you have when you select leads is to delete them. When you click the delete button, you are warned that the data will be permanently lost. So keep that in mind. If you delete a lead from this page, that data is gone. We cannot restore it for you. Now, in addition to these four options, if you're a site admin, you also have the ability to export your lead list. By clicking on this button, it will download a CSV file that has your leads within it that you can then open with a spreadsheet tool or any other tool that accepts CSV files. You have the ability to edit the lead types that are available within the CRM. And you also have the ability to edit the sources that are available within the CRM. So as an admin, you can modify those two different data types right here within the first page of the Contact Manager. Now I'm going to skip over activity plans and email designs for now. We'll talk about those in the next section. And then the last button on this page is the Settings button. When you click on this, you'll see that you have the ability to enter your email signature that you want to use throughout the system. And towards the bottom, you have the ability to control the SMS text notifications. These are notifications that ProAgent websites will send you. So you want to verify that your cell number is entered correctly here. You want to put in the time zone that you're currently in. And you want to put in the time from and to that you will accept SMS text messages from ProAgent websites. And then additionally down below, you have a more granular control where you can say, I want to receive text messages about new contacts, contacts that are assigned to me, when a contact is online, and when a contact has saved a favorite or saved a listing in their saved homes page. If you've made a change to any of these elements, in order to make it permanent, you'll need to click the Save button. So again, this is where you would go to edit your email signature and to set up your SMS text notification options. In this section, we're going to talk about working on individual leads. But before we do that, we have to be able to click on the lead. In this case, I'm going to bring up the filter list, select new leads, and I'm going to sort it by the most recent. Then I'm going to click refresh. Okay, so to get to a lead's detail, all we have to do is click on their name. And at that point, their detail will come up. Now, if I wanted to get back to the contact list, there's a button at the top. All I have to do is click on the contact list button, and it will bring me right back to the contact list, sorted exactly like it was before. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the lead detail.